Join our hosts as they step aboard the Seabourn LX26, a mid-size center console designed to handle rough water and fish in comfort. The Seabourn LX26 has an overall length of 26 feet 6 inches, a beam of 9 feet 8 inches, and a max horsepower rating of 500. Built for less than favorable conditions, she has a draft of 20 inches, a dead rise of 21 degrees, a weight of 5,000 pounds, and a fuel capacity of 135 gallons. Now, let's hear more from our hosts.
Guys, Seabourn today brought us their new LX26, and when I spoke to them earlier in the week, they said they designed this boat for the family who loves to go fishing. And so I'm already excited to see it today.
You know, I love boats without a lot of extra bells and whistles that you don't need, but everything that you do need, and that's what this boat speaks to me already.
Yeah, the template for the LX design, Rick, you know, is really a good one. In my opinion, I mean, this is a super functional boat, and one of the things that I admire about this company is that they build boats ready to go, and that's really important to a lot of people. These boats come ready to fish. This is a very nice looking boat, too. I'm really excited to see what it's gonna do on the water today.
Well, if this boat's so ready to go, I say, let's go.
One of the Seabourn models that we've seen a few different versions of over the years has been the LX24, and I'm a big fan of that boat. Well, new from Seabourn this year, this LX26, what a boat. Now, this is a boat that's really gonna give you all of the great attributes of the LX24, but really tailored more to the needs of a guy that wants to fish offshore primarily. Right off the bat, we're gonna talk about the size of this boat. This is a 26.5-foot by 9.5-foot beam. Now, 9.5-foot beam is a wide boat, and I've said in past shows that the 24 really seems like a lot beamier boat than it really is. Well, this boat actually has that beam, and it's a super stable platform, and you're gonna notice that right when you step on the boat. Now, a feature that I really appreciated on this boat was the helm layout. Since I'm usually the guy at the wheel on a boat all day, I can appreciate the visibility factor, and this boat had a curved glass windshield, which was very nice, but also you've heard me say over and over again how big a fan I am about countershaded tops and blacked out helm panels. Now that's really gonna help your visibility, especially if you're fishing. When you wanna see things on the water, you don't want glare blinding you. But also the gray underside and black tubing on your hardtop, it's very, very easy to see in the sunlight on this boat, and I like it.
The helm is so comfortable. And the seating with the bolsters that you can flip up and lean back into to run standing up or flip down and run sitting down are both positioned perfectly to make it a very comfortable ride.
This is a glass 24-inch one-piece display that recesses into the helm. More importantly, this is an information display system that integrates with the Seabourn electronics and switching.
I spent a lot of time today on the seat in front of the helm. It was actually my favorite. The cooler was right underneath me, and I really like the fact that they put a divider in the cooler. It makes it so nice to be able to separate your food and your drinks from one another. Also, two cup holders and safety rails on that seat. Really enjoyed it. What makes this so comfortable up at the bow is definitely these combing bolsters with plush cushions and removable backrest. Another cool feature for the family is the storage lockers under the bow seating. They're soft close, which makes it really nice so those little fingers don't get caught. The console provides you with so much storage that you can put a head in the boat if you want, it's an option, but if you don't, all those cushions in the bow that are removable can fit in that console along with your bags. That shows you how much room you have.
I've said it time and time again, one thing that I really appreciate about Seabourn boats is their access to systems. All the systems access from the bilge on the boat is really a wide open space. You can get to everything in your bilge. Access to all your electronic systems at the helm panel are easy from a standing position inside the console. You can reach everything there and see it well and get to it immediately. Also, the batteries are very accessible, and your switching for the batteries also very accessible.
The stern seating on the LX26 is permanent, but beneath it is a big oval live well. There's also a smaller live well over in the port corner.
So this LX26 is set up for the fishermen and the family. That walk-through transom door is great for your snorkelers and just getting on and off the boat at the sandbar. That dive door now, if you're diving, of course, easy to sit back with dive tanks, go on back, catch a fish, or if you're at the dock, just easy transfer of your friends and family to get on and off the boat.
The LX26 is max rated for 500 horsepower, and that means two engines. This boat with twin 250s is going to make you feel really good about getting way offshore in the blue water, and you're going to feel confident about the boat's ability to get you home. After having a chance to run this LX26 in some really rough conditions in the St. Lucie Inlet, I can see this boat is going to be a great addition to their line. This is a boat that's going to get you offshore, and if it was to satisfy the needs of the blue water fishermen, I think they absolutely hit the mark.
Let me tell you, I learned today I want another day on the Seabourn LX26. Gosh, that St. Lucie Inlet was choppy. I thought it was going to be rough handling. Handled like a dream. I want a day offshore on this boat.
I've always liked the design of the LX24. It's been a great boat for me. In my opinion, I really like the way that boat runs, and I like the deck layout. And this 26-footer is just more of that. It's the same kind of layout, just in a bigger boat. You can put a couple more people on the boat, and it's got a lot of new amenities added to it as well. It's a cool boat.
Well, speaking of amenities, I felt like it was the perfect amount, not overpowering the boat, because it kept the boat open, it kept it clean, but you had every functionality that you need to be comfortable on the water.
I didn't find anything not to like. There's plenty of real estate and everything you needed for amenities. I'm glad we got to spend the time on it. We did.